Good afternoon. My name is Amy Loeb, and I am the Deputy Executive Director here at Peconic Bay Medical Center. I'd like to welcome and thank you all for joining us on this very important and special day as we dedicate the Corey Critical Care Pavilion and the Canis Regional Heart Center. I would like to thank the community members, Northwell Senior Leadership, and our PBMC providers and staff who are here with us today. I would like to recognize the dignitaries here with us, especially Mark Woley from Congressman Lee Zeldin's office, Suffolk County Legislator Al Krupski, Assemblyman Anthony Palumbo, Riverhead Town Supervisor Yvette Aguilar and her Chief of Staff, Devin Higgins, former Town Supervisors Laura Smith and Sean Walter, Riverhead Town Council members Catherine Kent, Jody Giglio, and Tim Hubbard, Riverhead Town Justice Alan Smith, and Brookhaven Town Supervisor Ed Romaine. Thank you to our current and former elected officials who have all supported Peconic Bay Medical Center to become the regional medical center for the East End. A special thank you to Samantha Vigliotta from the PBMC Foundation and her team who have been instrumental in making today a reality. There are many people who have helped get us to where we are today. One of those people, Sherry Patterson, was expected to be with us today and act as the MC as I'm doing now. Unfortunately, this week we learned that one of Sherry's daughters is seriously ill, and so Sherry needs to be with her family right now. Sherry asked us to share this with you all. Sherry has been the chair of Peconic Bay Medical Center for 8 years and a member of the board for 20. She is a brave and remarkable leader, and I know she would be so proud to be here with us today. Sherry, I know that you are watching via live stream, and we want you to know that just as you have always been a brave leader and we have been behind you, we are all behind you today. In Sherry's place today to represent the PBMC board, it is my pleasure to introduce another longtime board member and advocate for our hospital, Gordon Huzzug.
Thank you, Amy. And I'd just like to echo what you said with regards to Sherry. I don't think there's been a board leader who has put more hours, more sweat, sometimes more aggravation, but has gotten more satisfaction out of where we are today than Sherry. And again, if we could just give her a round of applause, I'd appreciate it. I'd like to acknowledge the board of directors of the medical center. I know it's dark in here, but if you would mind just standing up to be recognized, I appreciate it. Whatever board of directors are currently here. Thank you. I'd also like to recognize the foundation board for all the work that they've done. And again, we're seeing the efforts of that. So foundation board members. Thank you. Our board of directors spent many years discussing what the future of our hospital would look like. We knew we needed to find a partner, and we also knew how monumental the decision we were making would be. After years of due diligence and investigating all of our options, we unanimously voted to join Northwell Health. And today, I stand in this building that will bring life-saving services to our community almost exactly 4 years after our signing ceremony in 2016, and Northwell, knowing without a doubt that we made the right decision for our community. The building will not only provide life-saving care, but it also provides an opportunity to continue to build upon our history of excellence by future expansions of our emergency department and other shell space that can now be used for future growth. And I'm sure right now where you're sitting in a few years is going to be part of that expanded emergency department. So it is with my pleasure to introduce someone who's been instrumental to Peconic Bay Medical Center, having the resources and human capital to make this possible, Michael Dowling, President and CEO of Northwell Health.
I want to say thank you, Gordon, and thank you for all your leadership and the leadership of the board here. What you've been accomplishing over the years is indeed special, and moments like this are really special moments. They're moments that you remember, and you remember them because of what has just been done here, what's above us that wasn't here just a few years ago. Just a few years ago when we sat here, this was open ground outside the facility. So today, it's special because we've created something special. You've created something special. It's a special moment also because of all the people involved. Because these things don't happen unless you have great people who are committed to doing great things. Those people are people in the community, people who are on the board, all of the people who've contributed, the donors who've contributed, the staff here at the hospital who contributed over $600,000 themselves to this effort. To the leadership at Northwell, many of them are here. We had a meeting here earlier today of all the leadership, the top leadership of Northwell Health. But today is also special because of what we're doing for the community and the legacy we leave for future generations. It's the people who will benefit from what has been built here. It's why this is so important and so unique and so special. It's also special because when you do something like this and you create something, it helps you think about the next thing you've got to create. Because everything builds on everything else. It's like, I'm sure many of you have been in the situation where your spouse says, you know, I'd like to fix the kitchen. And trust me, I'm only doing the kitchen. But that turns into the living room, the bedroom. And along the way, you complain and whine. How am I going to pay for it? Then it's all done. You sit back and you say, this was a great idea I had. Just think of what we've done here. So I want to say a special thanks, though, for in a special moment like this, to the Corey family, Michael and Emily. Thank you so much. And Elaine and John Canis, the Canis family. Because when people like you put your trust in the future and invest in helping future generations and put your trust in a location and a hospital like this, it means an awful lot. So you should all feel extremely, extremely proud. Because by your benevolence and your gifts, it helps others to think about what they should be doing and gets us all to think about what we should be doing and how we should be doing it better. You know, Peconic Bay, this facility is a great place. Just imagine where we were just not 10 years ago, which we gathered the whole facility and look at what's going on in this facility today. Just think of the patients that are being served today that couldn't be served here years ago. Think of the quality today that is so much improved from what was existed before. This is a hub location for this part of Long Island. It is a major priority for Northwell, this location. And now, of course, as you all know, we have locations with Southside and Mather and Huntington, just in Suffolk County, and all the ambulatory locations, and how we can all work together so that we're not singular in our thinking, we're collaborative in our thinking. To the extent to which we can all combine and collaborate and work as a team and think about the community around the facility here, but the community of Suffolk in general and the community of Long Island in general. In fact, if you think about it, because of the expanse of Northwell, the community of New York, we can make a difference. Well, let me say it another way. We do make a difference, but we can make a bigger difference. And to be in the healthcare field, being able to make sure that people have access to life-saving care, to be in a business where you can actually promote wellness, prevent illness, and then treat it once people become ill. Where you can watch people walking out of a facility at the end of the day in better condition than they did when they came in. Being able to see people come in with situations where most people would think that there is no way that they can be cured, and then watch them leave later on. Think of something that's more important. This is what community is about. And as everybody out in the political arena these days, and you're going to hear more about it in the next year and plus, talking about healthcare and what's wrong, and this is wrong and that is wrong, and we should go overseas and we should think of other places. While we acknowledge that we've got to continue to improve and do better, it's important to remind all of those naysayers that we do good work, that great things are happening, that people's lives are saved, that miracles occur every day, that we have wonderful staff, both nurses, physicians, administrative staff, that do great things, who dedicate their lives to improving the lives of others. Thinking as a community is important. At the end of the day, that's what we leave behind. A place that's a little bit better than when we found it. Today, because of what's being built here, and what will eventually be built in this location as you're now sitting, people will be better off because of it. People will walk in here years from now saying, what a great place, great facility, great technology, great people, great service. They may not know any of you or us, but they'll say, good people did this years ago. That's what's important. So I would say to all of you, and to Access Construction, to Ralph Lambert and his team sitting over here someplace, the people that built this, and all of the staff, because you can have a wonderful building, you can have all of the up-to-date artificial intelligence and everything you want to call it, but if you don't have great people, you don't have great program, and you don't have good outcomes. But to all who participated in this, on behalf of everybody at Northwell, all 72,000 employees, I will say to you, congratulations, thank you. You've created something that will lead to more creations in the future. You've built something that will continue to be expanded and grow. You've set a seed that is being fertilized, and that now, over the next number of years and decades, will expand. And just imagine what this facility, this community can be like a decade, 2 decades from now. You've got to think out that far. So today, special, a day to be proud, but it's what you set in motion that you've got to be more proud of. So I thank you. Thank you all for being here, and let me turn you back to this wonderful, unbelievably skillful Deputy Director, Amy. Okay.
Thank you so much, Michael. You always leave us thinking bigger. Today, we are Peconic Bay Medical Center, a proud member of Northwell Health. Our success and growth story is because of the hard work and dedication of many. And these many were inspired by a leader with fortitude, tenacity, and belief that we could be something more. Andy Mitchell often says, as a student of public health, he always knew that this community needed a comprehensive medical center. And for 20 years, he has made that his vision for leadership, and we have followed. I have worked with Andy for 4 years, and during that time, I have seen firsthand his steadfast dedication to bringing the best healthcare to the East End of Long Island. Because of his service and commitment to ensuring access to quality healthcare for this community, it is with the utmost respect that I introduce Peconic Bay Medical Center's President and CEO, Andy Mitchell.
Well, thank you, Amy. And thank you so much for stepping in at the last minute and being such a spectacular MC for this program. By the way, I think everyone knows we're live streaming this. We have a number of snowbirds down in Florida who have been part of the medical center for many years who are watching this. If you're the least bit jealous of their tan down there, just sit up here for about a half an hour. You'll have a great tan. I think I have the toughest job. It's impossible to go after Mike Dowling. And I really should just say whatever he just said. But I do want to make a few remarks if I could, and I will try to keep them brief, which I know is atypical for me. First and foremost, I too wish to recognize Sherry Patterson. Sherry was instrumental in making all of this possible, and I ask you to keep her and her family in your prayers. Today marks another huge milestone in Peconic Bay and Northwell Health's mission to serve the growing needs of a large swath of Suffolk County. There is a reason, folks, that the forefathers named this Central Suffolk Hospital, and it is actually in the center of Suffolk County. As we kick off a new decade together, we enter a new era of healthcare on the East End, and it's an era that really has no boundaries with our partnership with Northwell. None of this would be possible without your collective support, your leadership, and your incredible generosity. We express tremendous and heartfelt gratitude to all of you, and give yourselves a round of applause, please. To Michael Dowling, his amazing administrative team, Mark Salazzo, Steve Bello, Ralph Nappi is with us. Previously, Kevin Biner, Winnie Mack, and the incredibly dedicated entire Northwell leadership team, and my colleagues from Northwell who are here with us today. Northwell's significant investment in community hospitals is both demonstrative and, as you can see, very, very real. It is not a hub and spoke, folks. Northwell invests in developing new services in communities, and if you don't believe it, take the tour. It's truly incredible. Michael describes this as real healthcare reform, and we couldn't agree more. To Emily and Mike Corey, your devotion to our community and to our hospital is remarkable. Emily, your leadership of the PBMC Foundation is very, very special. We owe you a tremendous debt of gratitude. To Lane and John, and to John and Kate, and also to the Lechies, who performed a beautiful prayer earlier of the cath lab. Your support and inspiration and your guidance is truly invaluable. Thank you for all that you do for this hospital and the community. To our Hospital Foundation boards, thank you for trusting this crazy management team, the one here at the hospital, not Northwell's, they're not crazy, to create a regional medical center, to give us the latitude to, in fact, achieve the impossible. to the hundreds of donors, including our staff, who raised over $33 million in this campaign to make this evolution to a regional medical center possible. You truly define local philanthropy. We couldn't have done it without you. To Dr. Stanley Katz, a longtime friend, personal physician, who believed in this hospital so much that not only did he design the Katz Regional Heart Center, but he elected to become our full-time chief here at the hospital. Stanley, thank you. And Stanley, thank you for recruiting Andrew Persitz, who also brought his wife, who's a doctor here, to join us as an outstanding interventionalist and save lives here. Thank you. To our remarkable clinical support and administrative teams, the PBMC Medical Group and Northwell Physician Partners, you strive 24/7 to bring the best care to the nearly 250,000 men, women, and children who rely on us every day for care. To Ralph Lambert and the Axis Construction Team, you've been our expansion partners for 15 years. No matter what monkey wrenches we throw at you, and some of them are pretty large, your team marshals on to build these amazing facilities. I thank you. Almost done. To our elected officials, past and present, and especially to all of the town of Riverhead, your support is deeply appreciated, and we know today would not have been possible without your efforts to expedite approvals and rewrite zoning codes, among other things. Really, a lot of people said you can't do business in the town of Riverhead. Come talk to me. We do it all the time, and we partner terrifically. Thank you. I could go on and on. It would be impossible to thank everyone, as we would need to be here for days, and it's a nice facility, but I don't think anybody wants to do that. To put today in perspective, let me close with a quick story. It was 19 years ago when I first came here. I was 50 pounds lighter. I had hair. The headline on the front page of Southampton Press read, quote, "Central Suffolk Hospital future in doubt," end quote. I believe it referenced the looming bankruptcy of the medical center, not me actually coming here. Both happened around the same time, but they weren't associated, I don't think. Over the succeeding years, we not only disproved that headline, but we have grown to be the largest, most comprehensive, and successful healthcare system on the East End. 4 years ago, we joined Northwell Health, and we are, in fact, accomplishing the impossible. Thank you. We have worked so hard to make this happen, not for bragging rights, although maybe a little bit, but for the benefit of all the residents of the East End, for Ed Viola, who is with us today, as one of the miracles of the Corey Critical Care Pavilion and the Canis Regional Heart Center. Many of you know Ed's story, and it demonstrates the true mission of Northwell and Peconic Bay. And for all the future Ed Violas who will desperately need the life-saving skills of this medical center, we pledge to continue that quest for excellence. Thank you so much for being with us today, and thank you again for all your support.
Thank you, Andy. And now I am pleased to introduce two musical performers, Ms. Emma Cervone singing The Rainbow Connection, followed by Darren Otatti singing Somewhere Over the Rainbow, both accompanied by Jean DeLucy. Rainbows are visions.
is a hopeless jumble, and the raindrops tumble all around. Heaven opens a magic lane. When all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found. Leading from your window pane to a place beyond the sun, just a step beyond the rain, somewhere. In a lullaby, somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why can't I? If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why, oh, why can't I?
Thank you both. That was absolutely beautiful. At this time, I will ask that you turn to the last page in the program provided to you. We are honored to introduce an interfaith invocation presented by Reverend Charles Coverdale, Pandit Nareen, Imam Amin Rahman, Rabbi Michael Roscoe, Sister Margaret Smith, and Pastor George Summers.
We are here today
to invoke the blessings of the Spirit of the Infinite Life Force on these new facilities. Built with the hope and knowledge that many lives may be saved here, we wish to sanctify this space with our combined faiths. We also wish to summon sanctification for the many medical professionals, doctors, nurses, aides, and technicians who will work to care for those in need. We hope that their work will be guided by a belief the sacredness of the lives of their patients. We summon the forces of good to assure the outcomes of the work done here are achieved to the benefit of the patients, their families, and their communities. We thank those who have worked so hard to achieve this space, construction workers, architects, and engineers, planners, administrators, and the many donors in this community who have supported this important project. We entreat blessings upon them. Mindful of the uncertainties of life and the realization of our ignorance of the mysteries of the universe, we humbly beseech that the results of the work done here will be consistent with the universal plan that will give joy where there was fear, trust where there was confusion, and where there was chaos, let there be peace.
Thank you. You have inspired us all with that beautiful invocation. Now for our final song, You'll Never Walk Alone, sung by Mr. Stuart Whalen.
When you walk through the storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm is a golden sky and the sweet silver song of the lark. Oh, come through the wind, oh, come through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Oh, come, walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. You'll never walk
alone. Thank you, Stuart. That was so moving and appropriate for today. Thank you all for being a part of this very special day. This concludes our dedication. Please take some time to enjoy our dessert buffet and know that those who are going on a tour, the tours will begin shortly, leaving from the back of the room. Thank you all so much, and please have a safe journey home.